Investigators are trying to work out what started a unit block fire which forced a young woman to leap to her death. Eddie Meyer is at the scene in southwestern Sydney. Eddie, what can you tell us about the others who were injured?
Well, Hermione, what I can tell you is that there is another woman in hospital tonight in critical condition. She was one of the two women who jumped from the balcony. Her condition is critical. She suffered smoke inhalation burns and, of course, horrific injuries from falling five stories. Some 13 others were treated for smoke inhalation, are said to be stable. Now, the scene here this afternoon can only be described as one of chaos and panic. Now, we should warn you that the pictures you're about to see at the start of this report, you might find those distressing.
A moment so horrifying, it took bystanders completely by surprise. A moment when two women saw no alternative, stay in their burning apartment or risk a five-storey fall.
It's a fire and you saw some people is dropping from somewhere and it's continuously fire is coming, like, it's very, very horrified, yeah.
More than 50 others managed to escape down fire stairs as thick black smoke spread through the nine-level building.
I heard the fire alarm go off and I just thought it was just another false alarm, so I put the pillow over my head and went back to sleep. And then smelt the smoke not too long after that.
13 were taken to hospital suffering smoke inhalation. Dozens of others were assessed by paramedics at a nearby seniors club. Firefighters say the smoke was so thick they were forced to crawl from apartment to apartment to check for those who might have been trapped. No others were found. Hundreds of residents were unable to return to their units tonight, forced instead to find somewhere else to stay.
Now, fire investigators have been in the building all afternoon trying to work out exactly what caused it. They will be there again tomorrow, as will insurers and the strata managers, trying to work out whether the building is safe. Power has been cut. Residents are certainly not going to be back there much before tomorrow night, we believe. Hermione?
Thanks for the update. Eddie Meyer in Sydney. Qantas is banking on a new partnership with Emirates to save its international business. The airline will now stop over in Dubai rather than Singapore on its way to London. Flight schedules, frequent flyer points and airport lounges will be shared.
A key objective is to make Qantas International strong and viable and bring it back to profitability.
The deal could see Qantas earn $90 million a year. It comes 2 weeks after the airline posted its worst ever results. A High Court victory has paved the way for ANZ customers to recover millions of dollars in bank fees. Political reporter Leah Craven joins us live from Parliament House in Canberra. Leah, how close are they now to winning this case?
Well, now this case goes back to the federal court where a range of bank fees are open for challenge. Today's case was specific to the ANZ, but this is part of a wider class action where customers of up to eight banks are trying to claw back $220 million worth of fees. These are things like late fees, dishonor fees, overdrawn account fees. Today, the High Court accepted that some of these fees may be illegal, so it's up to the federal court now to decide whether they're fair and an accurate reflection of the bank's costs. Customers say no, this is not the case. They say it's completely out of proportion to what happens when, for example, a cheque bounces. They say it would cost the bank about a dollar, perhaps even less, for a misdemeanour like this, but they're charged somewhere between $25 and $45 for this. Now, the banks say that this is an uphill battle now, but they're prepared to fight and we can expect a very vigorous fight ahead. They say if this is returned in the customer's favour, this court decision, it could set a dangerous precedent and other companies that charge late fees and other such fees could be hit as well.
OK, we'll wait and see, Leah Craven. Thank you. The construction union has ended its blockade of several GrowCon building sites in Melbourne. During private talks tonight, the CFMEU agreed to stop unprotected action, which has disrupted work on at least four major developments in the past 3 weeks. Chief Executive Daniel Grollo says he's now happy to discuss any issue the union has with the company's operations. A woman has suffered shocking facial injuries in a savage pit bull dog attack. Christina Moyle was set upon by her friend's pet inside a house in Melbourne's north. It took 4 hours of surgery and more than 100 stitches to repair her injuries.
Jumped on me on the top, the two legs on front, and then the mouth got me on my face like this and didn't let go, I don't know how many seconds, until I had to punch the dog.
The local council says the dog is a restricted breed and plans to destroy the animal. A Queensland woman has told how a personal EPIRB saved her life during a trek in WA. 44-year-old Nivia Pryor was walking alone on the track 45 kilometres east of Perth when she slipped and was knocked out. When she woke up, she activated a GPS tracker which alerted her partner in Brisbane, who then contacted WA police.
I heard the vehicle pull up and then this gentleman here came around the corner and said, "Are you the lady?" I said, "I certainly am."
Nivia plans to tackle the track again once she recovers from her ordeal. And Kevin Rudd has warned Queensland Premier Campbell Newman his own party could turn on him. Mr Rudd was greeted like a Prime Minister as he strolled Brisbane's Queen Street Mall this morning and sued Wade into state government's public service job cuts. Up to 15,000 positions will be axed.
You are alive and you're looking you well, my friend.
For goodness sake, this guy's got 2.5 years left to govern. If you can do this in 6 months, what can you do in 2.5 years?
Speaking from experience, he says if Mr Newman doesn't change course, his party could dump him. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 19 degrees in Brisbane, 20 in Sydney, 9 degrees in Melbourne, 11 in Adelaide and 13 degrees in Perth.